Hello, Malek from Malek and Malek. Today I'm going to be talking about how BWC and work injuries that occur while being a truck driver. So, if you get injured as a truck driver in Ohio, like any other workers' comp situation, you may file an Ohio BWC claim. And it's the key thing is may. You have to always cabin things with may. There's two big issues that could come up, or two circumstances that could come up with truck driver injuries or injuries that occur while driving a truck. And again, these are injuries that, you get in a traffic accident and you're driving a truck, or you're unloading the truck and you get an injury. The contemplates these sort of things. But there's two circumstances that come up to more complicated situations. The first one I'm not going to talk about in this video, I'll talk about in a later video, and that's whether you are, if you get an injury while driving a truck, whether you're actually an employee of a trucking company or you're an independent contractor of, or you're an independent contractor. If you're an independent contractor, it'll go through a separate analysis. If you're found to be an independent contractor rather than an employee of a company, then you will not be able to file a workers' comp claim against an employer. Instead, if you have your own coverage, you could file a workers' comp claim against your own coverage. If you don't have any coverage and you're found to be an independent contractor, you're kind of screwed. So if you're a truck driver right now and you're not sure, you should probably figure it out. Figure out if you're an employee. If you're not, and if you're not an employee, figure out if you need to get workers' comp coverage. I'm not going to talk about that in this video. I'll talk about that in a video at a later time. It's very important. Courts will go through a number of factors. It's kind of similar to what they go through when determining whether a landscaper, for instance, is an employee or an independent contractor. There's some unique things about being a truck driver. In this video, what I'm going to be talking about is if you are a truck driver and you get injured in another state, can you file a workers' comp claim in Ohio? Why would you want to file a workers' comp claim in Ohio versus the state where you got injured? Maybe that the state where you got injured has doesn't have a great workers' comp system, or it's just more beneficial in compensation and the payment of medical benefits in Ohio. Now, if you get injured in a state that's really generous with their workers' comp system, it may make sense to file in that other state. So you have to see. And you may or may not be able to file in another state, but if you can, you may elect, hey, it's a better deal to file in another state. Each state has their own workers' comp system. Some states are better than others. Ohio is what is I think one of four states that has what's called a monopolistic system. Ohio sets up its own workers' comp situation, and most people employers pay what's into what's called the state fund. If you're a big enough employer, you'll have a self-insured. You basically fund your own workers' comp fund, but it's within the framework of the workers' comp fund established in Ohio. Again, some states aren't great. And I found a website, and I was trying to find that website, and I actually listed, for instance, body parts have different values depending on if you lose your body part in, say, Chicago versus Florida. It's kind of crazy, but it's thousands and thousands of dollars difference between how these states pay out. Why? I have no idea. It's how they do it. So in this case, it's called Lynch versus Mayfield. It's a good case. It lays down a fact pattern that's helpful in understanding how courts it applies a factor analysis and how courts in Ohio will look at at least this situation of a truck accident that happens out of another state. Basically, it comes down to what kind of contacts does Ohio have in that other state? So I'm gonna go explain the facts, and the facts are such that we have a truck driver. She was from Springfield, Ohio. She applied to work for JB Hunt in, I think, Lowell, Arkansas. She applied. She had to go undergo like a background check, a physical. She passed, and then she started working out of JB Hunt's shipping terminal in Lower Arkansas. She was controlled and supervised from that shipping terminal in Lower Arkansas, and this is important. And then she was paid by J.B. Hunt. Her checks came from Lowell, Arkansas. J.B. Hunt paid into a so Arkansas evidently didn't have like a workers' comp situation like Ohio. Instead, employers had they would pay into like an insurance coverage through like a typical, you know, like an insurance scheme, like you might pay for, you know, your house or whatever. But so their insurance scheme was paid independently, privately through an insurance company. They paid premiums to an insurance company, and then if somebody got hurt, they could file a claim, and then that insurance company, their policy would pay that person. So what happens is initially she's working from Lowell, Arkansas. At a certain point, she decides she wants to be based, or she transfers her base of operations to J.B. Hunt's shipping terminal in Springfield, Ohio. So evidently she had to go through a physical up there for some reason, but she went up through the physical up there. She passed, and then she, from that point on, she was supervising control from folks at that Springfield, Ohio shipping terminal of J.B. Hunt. That was her base of operations. So she would drive out from that Springfield, Ohio, all shipping terminal, all at all points in the United States. Like, and the specific situation in this case is she's driving from Springfield, Ohio. She has a load, and she takes it to Dallas, Texas. She drops off her load. She picks up another load in Dallas, Texas. And then she's going to take that to Lowell, Arkansas. So on the way out of Dallas, Texas to Lowell, Arkansas, she gets rear-ended, her truck does, and then she suffers a back injury and a neck injury. She doesn't see treatment until she finishes, or she arrives at Lowell, Arkansas. She drops off her load, and then she goes to a hospital, urgent care. So what ends up happening is J.B. Hunt files a claim against their policy, their employee injured employee policy in Lowell, Arkansas, and that policy pays out some medical benefits and some compensation. They don't ask the truck driver if she wants to file a claim in Arkansas, and in fact she doesn't. What she ended up doing is she files a claim in Ohio. That claim goes through the administrative process. It's denied at the DHO, SHO hearings. She files it to the Court of Common Pleas. It gets denied there. I think it gets kicked out summary judgment, actually. So then she appeals that to the Court of Appeals in the district where that where she filed it. And then the appellate court took it up, and then that's where we get this case, Lynch versus Mayfield, and how basically what they ended up doing is they say, no, she can file a claim, and it could be, you know, Ohio can maintain the jurisdiction of that workers' comp claim, even if it happened in, for instance, Dallas, Texas, which when you think about it, Dallas, Texas doesn't seem to have any connection to either Lowell, Arkansas or, you know, Ohio, but anyway, so they, in this case, they apply a five-factor analysis, and anytime you do, like with any case, whenever you do a five-factor analysis, it's going to be, they call it totality of the circumstances. They're kind of, not any one factor is determinative, and one factor may hold more weight than another factor. It just depends on how the court weighs them. They consider these factors, but not any one of them doesn't reign supreme. In this case, so they had five factors that they applied, that they considered. So the first factor was the locus of the employee's contract for hire. So basically that's a fancy way of saying where'd they hire this person. So in this case, she was hired in Lower Arkansas, so that would tend to suggest that that's a factor that goes towards having jurisdiction in Arkansas. The second factor was the locus of control and supervisions of the employee's job-related activities, i.e. who's supervising and controls the driver's routes, destinations, the type of truck driven, and goods to be transported. So in this case, that was the supervision and control occurred in the Springfield, Ohio shipping terminal. Her managers, her schedule, everything took place there. So that's a factor that goes towards Ohio having jurisdiction over this worker's over this injury. The third factor, where the work-related injury occurred. Again, it happened in Dallas, Texas. It's not really good for either Ohio or Arkansas, so maybe it's a neutral factor in this case, maybe a neutral result. The fourth factor, whether the injured worker was employed in Ohio or at a branch facility of a company which also happened to do business in Ohio. So in this case, it happened at the shipping terminal controlled by J.B. Hunt in Springfield, Ohio. So that factor would tend to go towards Ohio having jurisdiction over this workers' comp claim. And then finally, the fifth factor, in which state were workers' comp premiums were paid. So again, in this situation, premiums were paid in Arkansas, so that goes towards maybe Arkansas having jurisdiction. So let's look at it. We have, it looks like you have two for, two against, and maybe one neutral. And so in this case, they found that, I think what they found that the fact that the, she was supervised in Springfield, Ohio. That's her base of operations. I think they put a lot more weight in that, and less weight on these other factors. And also, I mean, that was a facility controlled or at least owned or controlled by J.B. Hunt. So in this case, again, they found that Ohio would have jurisdiction or could have jurisdiction. So that's not the end of the discussion. What they also go down further to say, and this is something that you have to consider is, so if a employee and employer or employer employee, they go further on, they say they may agree, to be bound by the workers' compensation system of Ohio or another state by signing an agreement in writing. And that must be filed with the Industrial Commission of Ohio within 10 days after execution. So after both folks sign that agreement, it has to be filed at the IC, Ohio Industrial Commission. So in this case, that did not happen. So and what they'll typically have you, there's two forms, and I'll put the links in there. I think it's a C-110 form and a C-112. And one of those forms, the Ohio BWC forms, one of those forms says, you know, the employee and employer agree that this worker's comp, this, you know, worker or will be bound by the workers' compensation system in Ohio. And then the other form says this worker will be, there's an agreement between the employee and the employer that worker will be bound, any injury or whatever, will be bound by the workers' compensation system in another state. So presumably you could sign that, and that is, you know, if it's a signed agreement, it's filed with the IC within 10 days after execution, that's fine. There might be some other way where you have a contract, so it might not actually be in that those forms. Instead, it might be in a contract. So you might want to look when you're applying at a company, say, that comes out of Iowa or some other state, your contract, when your employment contract, when you get hired, might say, there might be a clause in there saying that you are, you know, you are bound by the laws of wherever the state is. And I think there are some trucking companies that will have you do that. You got to be mindful of that, because again, it might be more beneficial to file a claim in Ohio. And I think some of these trucking companies, if they're going out of their way to make you bound by a state, another state, and again, you're kind of based in Ohio, but they're having you be bound by another state, I'd be interested to see what that workers' comp system, what existed in that state that they're wanting you to be bound by. Because usually, I mean, maybe this doesn't always happen, but usually, you know, companies, when they do stuff like that, they go out of their way to do things. You got to kind of look and be like, okay, what are they trying to do? What right am I giving up? What benefits am I giving up? Am I making it more hard to file a claim, etc.? I would be skeptical, and I would go through with a critical eye and figure that stuff out. Because it may, again, it may be that you're signing away significant rights. It might be, maybe it's not worth applying for that company. You might want to look at a different trucking company. But in this case, there was no signed agreement. Ohio may retain, so it's again may, but they're going to remand this back to court. But Ohio retained jurisdiction over this workers' comp claim. And then, so what they said in this case, since, so this lady had received benefits in Arkansas, because she had received benefits, compensation, medical benefits in Arkansas, if she applied for compensation and benefits in Ohio, any benefits paid out by the Ohio's workers' comp system would be offset by benefits paid out by whatever the other situation is. So, so if there was medical and compensation paid out in Arkansas, this case basically says those are, any benefits paid out from Ohio are gonna, they're gonna reduce those benefits by benefits already paid. They don't want people to double dip. That's basically the bottom line. So you can't be cute and file a claim in, you know, say Kentucky, get a bunch of benefits and be like, ah, I didn't want a claim in Kentucky, I want in Ohio, and file in Ohio and then try to get double benefits. That's not gonna work. So so bottom line is, and this is a situation where somebody was a truck driver, got injured in another state, and was able to file a claim in Ohio under Ohio's workers' comp system. I'll be probably going over some other truck accident cases that further define this particular field. But bottom line is, you may be able to file a workers' comp claim in Ohio if you're injured in another state. But what I would do if that does happen, and you're, if you're based in Ohio or you're driving, in Ohio and you get injured, or you're driving out of Ohio and you work, or like you work, let's say from a company, another state, and you're driving in Ohio and you drive back and forth in Ohio. Even if you're not based in Ohio, so the fact that you're driving back and forth, you're delivering in Ohio, you may have a claim. So these situations, there's other cases I'm going to talk about that further define how this will work. This is one example, and this is an example of how they use this factor analysis. My suggestion with everything workers' comp related, my suggestion is you talk with a workers' comp attorney. At least voice your facts and circumstances with your situation. Most all workers' comp attorneys, including us, Malek and Malek, will listen to you. We'll give you a free consultation. If we will give you the advice that we can within the limits of the fact that we're not representing you at that point. But if we think you need representation, we will absolutely recommend you get representation. If, again, as always, if we don't think you necessarily need it, that this is at this particular point, we'll tell you that as well. So if you call us for free consultation, that's exactly what it is. It's a consultation. It's not, hey, sign up. So if you want to sign up with us, that's, you can do that. But anyways, if you have questions or concerns, please email me, kip@malek.com, or give us a call, 614-444-7440. Otherwise, stay safe. If you have any other topics or questions, always post them in the comments. And if you have like a particular workers' comp area that you want me to cover, I'll try to get to it. Otherwise, thank you for listening. Goodbye.